Gleam Davis single-handedly closed down Village Trailer Park with her swing vote, making the vote a 4-3 majority vote against the people and for the developer, a $60 million financial gift to the developer. Gleam Davis's vote displaced 68 families. What is the drive behind gifting such large financial benefits to developers? The California Fair Political Practices Commission's secret two-year investigation discovered nearly $100,000 of dirty laundered money as contributions to three council incumbents running for re-election for the Santa Monica City Council. During the CVRA lawsuit in March 2018, Kevin Schenkman, the attorney for the plaintiffs in the Voting Rights Act lawsuit, received a judicial referee's nod to pry into matters, such as Huntley's contributions, to look for a pattern of wrongdoing. The Huntley Hotel gave nearly $100,000 in contributions in the names of other entities to three incumbents running for Santa Monica City Council. The City of Palmdale, California settled a CVRA lawsuit in 2015. Palmdale Mayor Jim Ledford has been charged with illegally receiving nearly $500,000 from local consultants and failing to publicly disclose the income on economic statements, prosecutors said. Ledford, 63, has been charged with conspiracy and conflict of interest and three counts of perjury, according to the Los Angeles County District Attorney. The two consultants, Kimberly Ann Shaw, 61, of Yorba Linda, and Susan Miller, 68, each face charges of conspiracy, embezzlement, and misappropriation of public funds. The drive behind gifting such large financial benefits begins to become noticeable if dirty laundered money can reach our elected representatives in a public forum such as political donations, then dirty laundered money can reach our elected officials privately. Oh, and just like Palmdale's Mayor Jim Ledford, Gleam Davis is Santa Monica's mayor.